Virgo. I have been feeling so drawn to pull your cards for love reading for February 2019. My name is F9. I'm an intuitive reader. I'm a raw reader. So my content, I curse. I speak the truth. Whatever knowledge or message comes through from spirit, I say it. So if you're very conservative or you're not free or open-minded, then my channel isn't the channel for you. Virgo, I keep hearing in my head this silly song. I'm not a fan of the song, but it's the rather be with you on all your bullshit. I'm looking intensely at Carnelian right now for you guys. Intuitive-wise, I feel like a lot of you are kind of in a place where you want to be okay with being single, if you're not in a relationship, or even if you are in a relationship, I'm sensing that maybe you're having thoughts about if it's better if you would rather just by yourself. Like, do you want to deal with somebody and all their bullshit? So how this works is, that was an intuitive message for whoever needed it. How it works is I pull one card from three of my decks. If spirit guides me to pull more, I will. Okay. I make these love messages for every astrological sign. Very simple, short and cute. If this resonates with you, feel free to hit me up for a personal message. I am donation based. Could have been over exhausting yourself, Virgo. I just pulled take a nap card represented by number 24. I've been saying 24 all over the place. 24 is my magical number, but this can be taking a nap from being in your head too much about a relationship, about career, about your foundation right now. Once again, it matches perfectly up. Make sure you see the card good. It matches perfectly with the Carnelian, so there's a lot of root chakra work that needs to be done in order to heal your subconscious. We have the moon here, we have air here, so that's Aquarius, Libra, or Gemini you could be dealing with maybe. Maybe Aquarius, Libra, or Gemini is your moon sign. If you don't know what moon signs are, I highly encourage you guys to get your natal chart done. If you have questions about natal chart, feel free to message me about that too. But all of this has to do with maybe things that is on your mind subconsciously. Maybe your dreams have been very intense. Maybe your dreams have been draining you. Maybe you've been receiving a lot of downloads through your dreams. When it comes to this specific love partner, but there is something that needs to be healed within your root chakra and your sacral chakra, I'm seeing, when it comes to this love partner. Or maybe you're feeling like you should take a break from this person. Yeah, we have the star in reverse. You could be dealing with an Aquarius, more air energy. Usually when the star is reversed, it's kind of like you're feeling stuck and hopeless, or maybe you're not filled with as much faith as you normally would be. You're kind of like losing insight, losing motivation, losing power. You feel like when it comes to this certain relationship, maybe you feel like it's not going anywhere. Maybe you feel like it's more so of a curse than a blessing, I'm hearing. We have the girl. She's kind of like, it looks like she's bringing the star right back the hell up when it came from. You know, maybe a lot of relationships have ended for you, Virgo, but I'm saying that you have to be by yourself for the next couple of days. You need rest. Definitely, because you have a lot on your mind, and I feel like with the overwhelming feeling, of thinking too much into this relationship, it's just not putting you in a good space. Okay, get one card from my goddess tarot deck. Virgo, love, February 18th. sounds to me like you're tired of their bullshit. We have two goddess cards that decided to come out. We have Diana, who represents divine wisdom, high priestess energy, all-knowing. You have the knowledge and the wisdom within yourself at this moment. The veil is thin. You're very enlightened. Use your intuition. If you feel like something isn't right, if you feel like someone is using you, abusing their powers that they may have over you, emotional abuse I'm hearing for some of you, or someone might be using you materialistically, you know. Diana says, you have the divine knowledge that you can help others through your spiritual teaching. This is all a lesson I'm hearing. Perhaps you met this person in school. Perhaps this person could even be a teacher, or they started off as a mentor. Definitely someone older than you. I'm feeling like someone could be actually into you. That I'm hearing for a majority of you, not a majority, a minority of you, that it could be even someone that you're not interested in, that has feelings for you, and you know that they have feelings for you, and they've just been doing too much, and it's kind of like exhausting you in a way, because you kind of don't want to be around them that much, or maybe you feel like you need a break from them, and it's just like in your head, you're just like, I literally don't know why this person likes me this much. It's not going to go anywhere. They could even be feeling like, damn, this shit really isn't going to go anywhere. This person isn't budging to the love that I'm giving them. This could be a past life connection, or the person you're dealing with could be a twin flame. I'm hearing third party, so maybe you're stuck in between two people. Two people could be interested in you, Virgo. You could have someone that has two people. But I'm usually getting that this energy is you, just because we have this divine priestess, high priestess card here. High priestess with also, it's kind of like all powerful feminine energy. Virgos are very grounded. We have earth all up and through here. Iso is undying love, so this could be someone that likes you a lot, that just seems like they're not gonna give up on you. This could be an ex, this could be, like I said, an admirer. This could be you feeling some way about someone, like you can't get over someone. Iso came up in someone else's reading. It might have been Taurus. That's another earth energy. So earth energies is going through a lot of undying love and stuck in between two partners, I feel like. The love you have shared is eternal regardless of the situation. So it could be a little rocky right now. Maybe you were with someone who wasn't showing you the love that someone else was showing you. I'm feeling like I told Taurus, also she was kind of stuck in between, I think, a king and a knight. But the knight, of course, was her like twin flame. And the king was the king, like he was providing, but he wasn't, you know, the king was still messing around with other peasants and girls and mistresses and whatnot. And the knight made, I believe, Iso happy, you know what I'm saying? So this could be an underdog, you know, someone that no one expected you to kind of like be in cahoots with, not cahoots, but in a relationship with, maybe, for some of you Virgos. Like, you could be working with someone. And you can already have someone, or maybe you're working with two girls that are into you. One's more in a higher position, one's more older. The other one could be younger, or maybe your age group, but just doesn't have that much power as the older person. Either way, though, someone is teaching you a lesson. You're teaching someone a lesson, Virgo. That's definitely the case. I'm putting out it to pull more. It's getting kind of juicy. I'm hearing that some of you guys could be having sexual feelings for these two, or the knight, the underdog, counterpart. Also, Virgo, February 2019, love energy. Getting stuck, like you're like, you guys could feel possibly. I'm getting a sense like, you feel like you're treading through sticky, muddy waters, like it's kind of difficult to walk through the water. Like, you're kind of slowed down. You feel like... But you're trying to go with the flow as much as possible with to the sea card here. This person goes with the flow. This person, you could be dealing with a water sign. Or you, water is Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. Or you could be actually so into taking this time out with this take a nap here that you could be actually diving deep into your emotions, diving deep into your feelings and your subconscious here. As we have High Priestess Diana, whose subconscious energy, the moon. Okay? I'm hearing like Virgo moons. If you have a moon sign in Virgo, you can definitely be feeling these energies intensely. But to the sea is someone that goes with the flow, allow spirit and the universe and God to intervene. So like just take the wheel, Jesus take the wheel with this situation. Number seven is a highly spiritual number. It represents learning and victory and growth and spiritual enlightenment. Downloads like no other. You're gaining a lot of information from this entire situation. Whether you're gaining information from one party or another, one lover or another, you're gaining as much information as you need through dreams and through this physical plane of existence. I'm hearing that let the person talk and just listen. Because if you let someone talk enough, they'll tell you everything you need to know. You've been questioning why a certain situation had to be the way that it has. Again, we have fire energy. You could be dealing with Leo, Aries, Aquarius. It matches up perfectly with your carnelian. I'm hearing again, your root chakra, your sacral chakra is being affected by the situation. You're asking why it happened. My suggestion, sorry, my throat is all raspy. My suggestion is to look dived in deep, maybe, into your childhood and see what happened and occurred in your childhood to see why the situation has been brought up again. Okay? But there's no exact why. Spirit will let you know in due time why this has occurred, but just know that it has occurred for the best. And I'm hearing also, if you're hung strong on someone that you might have broke up with, that you're asking why it happened, but you only want to know why, maybe perhaps because you need closure, or this person needs closure. Okay? Why is represented by 31, vibrations of 3 and 1. Maybe this situation has affected you to the point where it's kind of affecting your manifesting and creating techniques. But again, this has to all do with yourself. I think right now, Virgo, the best thing for you to do, of course, is, like I said, take this nap, take time out, take a couple days off. If you're working too much, don't. Just get grounded and rest as much as you can. And because this is a decision that you need to make, okay, when it comes to whether you're in a third-party situation or you're the party thrower, okay? But you have all time with them right now. You know what's right. You know what's wrong. You know who's probably for you. You know who's not. And if you have no idea, lay back, relax, because it's all gonna, the fuckery will unfold, okay? The tea will come in. The ships will come in. I'm seeing Three of Wands energy in my head. You're just waiting for something to happen. And again, Three of Wands represents third-party situations. So I'm going to cut it there, Virgo. Like I said, I hope this resonated with all of you. If you guys have any questions or you want to connect with me, my information, my email's in the description box below. Feel free to follow me on Instagram and Twitter. What else? I'm donation-based. I take as low as $3.33 if you want a reading, personal. Like, share, and subscribe. The more views I get, the more likes I get from every sign, the more content I put out for that sign. So I love all of you, and have a wonderful, wonderful week.